L cross H is equal to J plus dou D by dou T. You know this? Where J is equal to sigma E. J is equal to sigma E. I am writing in phasor notation. I am writing the now what happens, del cross H is equal to sigma E plus, phasor notation is dou by dou D is equal to J omega D. Del cross H is equal to sigma E plus J omega epsilon E. What is this term? This is a sigma J. J is nothing but current density. Generally this is J, conduction current density. Sigma term, you can make it as JC, conduction current density. Conduction current density. This is J omega epsilon E or dou D by dou T. Dou D by dou T, we know the, from Maxwell's equations, what is this? It is displacement current density. Displacement current density. So the first term is conduction current density, the second term is displacement current density. I can indicate with a JD. Now what I am doing, I am taking the ratio JC by JD. The ratio of conduction current density to displacement current density. The ratio of conduction current density to displacement current density. And what is the ratio? Sigma E by J omega epsilon E. Ratio. Then I'm taking the magnitude part. That's the magnitude part. Then what is the thing? E cancels out. Magnitude of J is 1. The only thing remaining is sigma by omega epsilon. Sigma by omega epsilon. So this ratio sigma by omega epsilon is also known as, with a particular term known as loss tangent. This term sigma by omega epsilon, that is the ratio of conduction current density to displacement current density, is also known as loss tangent, with a particular name. Loss tangent. That is, it is indicated by tan theta is equal to sigma by omega epsilon. So also called loss tangent, this ratio sigma by omega epsilon, and also it is also called as dissipation factor. Anyway, based on this ratio sigma by omega epsilon, materials are classified. That is, this sigma by omega epsilon is very very greater than 1. The materials are known to be good conductors. That is, it has more sigma value. If sigma by omega epsilon value is very very less than 1, then they are said to be good dielectrics are very low sigma value insulators. Good dielectrics are insulators. Generally, it's also called as loss tangent, tan theta is equal to sigma by omega epsilon. Intrinsic impedance is square root of j omega mu by sigma plus j omega epsilon. This I can write some magnitude and some phase angle theta n. Generally, the relation between this theta and theta n is theta is equal to 2 theta n. Theta is equal to 2 theta n. Theta is equal to 2 theta n. So tan inverse sigma by omega epsilon. Based on this property sigma by omega epsilon, we can classify the materials. That is, if sigma by omega epsilon is very very greater than 1, it is a good conductor. If the value is very very less than 1, then it is a good dielectric or insulator. And the relation between theta, where tan loss tangent, and intrinsic angle is theta is equal to 2 theta n. Now we will say, based on these properties, how the equations looks like in different media. Suppose I am mentioning plane waves in free space. Plane waves in free space. Free space means sigma is equal to 0. What is epsilon value? Epsilon is equal to epsilon naught. Mu is equal to mu naught only. In free space, what is alpha value? Free space, alpha, suppose if you want to calculate alpha, we know then the general formula. Alpha is equal to omega into square root of mu epsilon by 2 into square root of 1 plus sigma by omega epsilon whole square minus 1. This is alpha value. For free space, sigma is equal to 0. So substitute sigma is equal to 0. So this is entire thing is 0. So square root of 1 minus 1. So entire thing is 0. So you multiply with 0. So the entire thing is 0. So alpha is equal to 0. That is, in a free space, attenuation constant is 0. There is no attenuation at all. Of course, practically we have a little bit of attenuation, but it is almost all equal to 0. Alpha is equal to 0. Then the equations are looks like this. E is equal to, for a more, that is for a general conducting medium, we already discussed the wave equations. E is equal to E naught into e power minus alpha z cos omega t minus beta z ax cap, where the wave is propagating in positive z direction. Now here alpha is equal to 0. Then the equations looks like this. E is equal to E naught, there is no attenuation term, cos omega t minus beta z ax cap. Then what happens to H? H is equal to some H naught into cos omega t minus beta z ay cap. Here there is no theta n, because what is theta? Theta is equal to general formula j omega mu by sigma plus j omega epsilon. Only magnitude part for sigma is equal to 0 for free space. Only mu naught by epsilon naught present. So only magnitude. There is no phase at all. Therefore h naught is nothing but e naught by eta. E naught by eta, where eta is only magnitude, we are having square root of mu naught by epsilon naught. So these are the more general equations in free space. Here we know that why it is ay, because here the wave is propagating in positive z direction, means az component. So e cross h is equal to az. E is given ax. So obviously h component is ay. Now plane waves in good dielectrics, good or lossless dielectrics. Plane waves in good or lossless dielectrics. We know that for a lossless electrics or good electric, sigma by omega epsilon is very very less than 1. If you substitute this value for more for general conducting medium values, that is alpha and beta value, since this is very very less than 1, almost all we can neglect this term. Sigma by omega epsilon whole square we can neglect. So if you substitute in alpha, general alpha, so alpha is approximately we will get 0. Then epsilon is equal to epsilon naught into epsilon r. Since it is a dielectric medium, it has some relative permittivity. So epsilon, not only epsilon naught, it is epsilon naught multiplied with epsilon r. Similarly, mu is equal to mu naught mu r. Mu naught mu r. So E and H. Now E and H. So what about E and H? Similarly, since alpha is almost all equal to 0, E is nothing but E naught into cos omega t minus beta z ax cap. The wave is up, I am assuming, propagating in positive z direction. H is equal to some H naught cos omega t minus beta z ay cap. What is the difference? It is similar to a free space only, but the only difference is in eta. Eta here is mu naught mu r by epsilon r at an angle of 0 degrees. Since alpha is equal to 0, angle is 0. So a lossless dielectric is almost all the equations are similar to a plane wave only, but the only difference is in eta value. In eta value, here we are considering relative permittivity also into account. Now we will see plane waves in good conductors. Plane waves in good conductors. Plane waves in good conductors. We know that sigma by omega epsilon is very very greater than 1. Sigma by omega epsilon is very very greater than 1. Epsilon is equal to epsilon naught epsilon r, mu naught is equal to mu naught mu r. Then alpha. Alpha is equal to square root of omega into general formula is omega into mu epsilon by 2 into square root of 1 plus sigma by omega epsilon whole square minus 1 alpha. Beta is only here plus 1. Since this sigma by omega epsilon is very very greater than 1, whole square is very very greater than 1. So I can neglect this 1 value here. I can neglect this 1 value. I can neglect this minus 1 also. So the remaining thing is alpha is equal to omega into square root of mu epsilon by 2 into square root of sigma by omega epsilon whole square only. It comes out of the root, it is only sigma by omega epsilon. So what is the remaining thing? So this is nothing but alpha is equal to, take this omega into inside the root, it becomes omega square. So this is omega square mu epsilon sigma by 2 omega epsilon. Epsilon epsilon cancels, omega 1 omega cancels. The remaining thing is square root of omega mu sigma by 2. Omega mu sigma by 2. Omega mu sigma by 2. Similarly, beta. Beta only the thing is here plus. So I can neglect either minus 1 or plus 1. I can neglect 1. So beta also I will get the same value. Therefore, alpha is equal to beta is equal to square root of omega mu sigma by 2. Alpha is equal to beta is equal to square root of omega mu sigma by 2. This is also equal to square root of pi f mu sigma, because omega is equal to 2 pi f, 2 to cancels, pi f mu sigma in terms of f, pi f mu sigma. Similarly, for good conductors, what is the eta value, intrinsic impedance? I know the general formula, that is for any conducting medium, eta is equal to square root of j omega mu by sigma plus j omega epsilon. J omega epsilon. Then this is equal to, I am changing it to j omega mu. I am taking sigma common here, 1 plus j omega epsilon by sigma. Since sigma by omega epsilon is very very greater than 1 for good conductors, omega epsilon by sigma is very very less than 1, very very less than 1, so that I can neglect this entire term. I can neglect this entire term because approximately I can take as 0. So then what is the remaining thing? Is nothing but square root of j omega mu by sigma. J is nothing but 1 magnitude. J is nothing but what? Magnitude 1, angle 90 degrees. So this eta is equal to this square root of 1 magnitude 90. I am taking out this one. So I get only omega mu by sigma at an angle 45 degrees. At an angle 45 degrees. So what are the general equations here? Suppose E is equal to E naught e power minus alpha z, because alpha exists, cos omega t minus beta z ax cap. Then H value is equal to E naught by magnitude of n, square root of omega mu by sigma e power minus alpha z cos omega t minus beta z minus theta n. Theta n is 45 degrees. So this is Ay cap. So these are the general equations for E and H in a good conductor. So we can conclude that in a good conductor E leads H by exactly 45 degrees. E leads H by 45 degrees. So which is very very important conclusion. In the examination, suppose if they give E and H, so these equations resembles for which medium? So suppose if the angle is minus 45 degrees, we can say directly it is a good conductor. Even though if it is approximately equal to 45, we can say that the medium is a good conductor. That's why if you observe the entire thing here, that is the plane waves in free space, plane waves in a good dielectric or lossless dielectric, or plane waves in a good conductor, the entire thing is based on the basic general equations, that is del square E minus gamma square is equal to 0, del square H minus gamma square H is equal to 0, where gamma square is equal to j omega mu into sigma plus j omega epsilon, alpha is equal to omega into square root of mu epsilon by 2 into 1 plus square root of square root of 1 plus sigma by omega epsilon whole square minus 1. For beta it is plus 1. So if you keep in mind these formulas, these are more general formulas. So you can derive for any medium, any particular medium with the different properties, what are the basic equations forms. And of course you can calculate alpha, beta and intrinsic impedance values also directly. If you remember the standard wave equations and standard wave equations values, alpha, beta, gamma values. And one more here important conclusion is, if the medium is a good conductor, the E field, that is the electric field, leads a magnetic field by exactly 45 degrees, which is very very important conclusion. You have to keep in mind this thing. There may be chance for asking directly in the examination. One more important point we observed here is, as the waves E and H are propagating in a conducting medium, as the waves E and H travels in a conducting medium, its amplitude is attenuated by, its amplitude is attenuated by a factor of e power minus alpha z, because there is attenuation exists. That is, suppose the wave is propagating in z direction, z is equal to 0. As a wave is initially it has amplitude e naught, as the wave is propagating into the medium, its amplitude decreases like this. So amplitude decreases. So there is a particular distance known as lambda. So the distance lambda, as shown in figure, through which So at this distance, definitely the amplitude is somewhat less than E naught, somewhat less than E naught. So this lambda is a particular distance. So lambda is a distance. So lambda is a distance through which the wave amplitude, decreases by a factor of e power minus 1 or 37%. The wave amplitude decreases by a factor of e power minus 1 or 37% of its initial value. It's a initial value. That is e power minus 1 e naught. E power minus 1 e naught. So at this particular lambda distance, it is e power minus 1 e naught or 37% of its initial value. There is a particular name called this as called skin depth. Skin depth or penetration depth. Skin depth or penetration depth. So skin depth or penetration depth is nothing but a distance as the wave is propagating in the conducting medium. At a particular distance, the amplitude decreases to a particular factor of 37% or e power minus 1 of its initial value. That particular distance is called skin depth. That particular distance is called skin depth. Then this skin depth is given by lambda is by 1 by alpha. Lambda is given by 1 by alpha, where alpha is attenuation constant. We know for any medium alpha value, we know. For good conductors, generally, for example, for good conductors, what is lambda? Lambda is equal to 1 by alpha. Alpha, you know, alpha is equal to square root of pi f mu sigma in terms of f. So lambda is equal to, or skin depth is equal to 1 by skin depth is equal to 1 by square root of pi f mu sigma 1 by square root of pi f mu sigma. This is for a good conductor. Or for any medium, if you want to measure the skin depth value, you can calculate directly alpha value. So because alpha we know for any medium, the general formula you can use. So the skin depth lambda is given by 1 by alpha. For a good conductor, the skin depth is 1 by square root of pi of mu sigma. So skin depth is nothing but it's a distance through which the wave amplitude decreases by a factor of e power minus 1 of its initial value.